Hello and ahoy. This is the news. After ordering 48 oysters, a woman on TikTok went viral when she was unexpectedly ditched in the middle of her date. The man that ditched her said he wasn't bothered by the number of oysters, but it was the amount of teeth that she used while sucking them down.
Starting in 2025, digital streaming service Netflix is planning on opening physical media storage. I didn't know this. This is kind of crazy. Rumor has it that they'll be placed in strip malls across the nation, right next to Dollar Tree and a Rub and Tug.
I'm excited.
Yeah. Yeah. Convenient for the family.
Yeah. Everybody gets something.
Everybody.
Toy section and then the Dollar Tree.
Yeah.
Pfizer has more than doubled the price of COVID-19 medication Paxlovid, now charging almost $1,500 for a five-day treatment. Ooh. When a Pfizer spokesperson was asked why the treatment is so expensive, he made the sound of a cash register and began making it rain $100 bills while humping the air.
Well, that's inappropriate.
I feel like that one wasn't even a joke. That's just what happened.
Yeah. That sounds real.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's crazy.
Yep.
Yours sounded like jokes. That one sounded real.
Yeah, that one very real. I liked how you read that. You did very good.
That was good. Yeah.
Yes. I did not write a joke about Paul Pelosi being hammer sex for the guest today. Anyway, welcome to Normal World. I'm Dave Landau.
I'm Quarter Black Garrett.
Hi, I'm Angela, and thank you, Jason Megdanoff, for my beautiful leather face. You megged and got me off with that. So thank you.
Look at that.
I appreciate it.
It's a Halloween spectacular.
Nice. Thank you. Send me more.
And our guest.
Send me more.
You should. She does a lot. I'm going to say she does a ton for the show.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Like almost everything.
Yeah.
So I just want to say thank you to
her. I'll give you $20 after the show. Thank you for saying that.
Yeah. No, it's fine.
Really great. Yeah.
It's 30. But
I'm over all your plans and everything. Just like.
No, really, she's a very big asset, and yes. I think people should know that.
I don't have a big asset.
Also inappropriate.
It's not big. It's droopy.
You went from one spectrum of inappropriate to the other.
I didn't even know.
That's why we do this.
Well, if I made it not a joke,
if
how
you said
weird
it's
would
pert,
that be?
It would be weird.
If I was like, no, it's great.
Legit, that is weirder.
No, anyway, I just want to compliment.
Yeah.
All right, now
guys. It's enough. It's enough. Get to it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
You owe me money.
It's weird. I don't like this.
And now our guest, also, was the spectacular.
Is it perky or something?
I can't do this. A perky. Today we are joined by the very funny comedian, Jen Murphy.
Oh, thank you.
You can see her on her show, Jillianoff.
Jillianoff.
Why did I say Jilly? Oh, because I'm illiterate.
No, because you probably are like, what is Jillianoff?
What is Jillianoff?
I didn't know what it was until my co-host thought of the name, and I just played along because I thought, well, am I the only one that doesn't know what this is? Apparently, it's the female version of masturbation, like Jack and Jill.
See, now I get it.
I totally get the connection now. I'm so dumb.
Are you Canadian? Because my co-host is Canadian. I'm like, maybe it's a Canadian thing.
No, but it just made perfect sense to me because I love masturbating.
There you go.
So does my co-host.
Comment section is very happy about that.
Yeah, right now there's a couple people that are mad and then 99% of them that aren't.
Well, hey, speaking of actually the data, I have a special report from the data last night. We had our scientist on, our chocolate lesbian scientist, and he gave some data, and we put a poll out for the audience, and you guys answered it. So here are the results. We have 51% straight males like milk chocolate.
Look at that.
Oh.
It's a very drastic change here. 7% of straight females like dark chocolate. 2% of lesbians like milk chocolate. And 40%, which is very shocking, 40% of asexuals watch the show that did not answer. So
I feel like there's a lower amount of females that watch this show. So I feel like the results are maybe skewed.
Yeah.
It's maybe, but hey, that's just how polls work.
We have an odd amount of number of females that watch. It's something in like the 3 percentile.
Yeah.
Which well, for a it's 9%. This show is stunning.
It's 9% according to the data. So if you're mad about, hey, if you say you're straight and you like dark chocolate, I'm sorry, that's just the data.
Were there any comments?
Don't get mad at us.
Do we have comments?
We have several.
Oh, so many.
We have several. I don't know if we can show them now. Oh, we can. Okay.
Yeah, there's one, and then that's just normal world explaining that they are a gay man.
Yes, that is the data that shows. I'm sorry. Don't shoot the messenger. It's science.
Isn't dark chocolate better for your sex drive?
I don't know about that. We don't go that deep into the science of chocolate, just the sexualities of people that like the chocolate.
Okay. Judging how I feel, probably.
Yes.
It's good for your heart.
Yeah. We love you anyways. It's okay. It's just how you are.
Well, there's ripped guys that was really funny where they're just like, milk chocolate's for cucks and fatties. And it's like, you meant that.
Hey.
Really meant that. I can tell by your picture.
You're mad about it. That's okay.
Well, let's get into it.
It's okay to be
gay. Chocolate.
The chocolate?
What?
Huh?
No? The news. Did we do the news?
Did we?
Sidney Powell.
Who is this?
Earlier today, Fulton County prosecutors dropped all 7 felony charges against Sidney Powell.
Really?
In exchange for a misdemeanor plea.
Oh, so she pled. That's a drastic difference.
A guy?
That on the picture,
that's
yes.
A guy, yeah.
Why they show...
That's Kendall.
Is Sidney Powell a guy?
That's the newscaster.
It's not that guy.
No, Sidney Powell's a woman. That's the newscaster.
That's a Ken.
Reporting it.
That's what I thought. Well, why? All right. So,
give me some help here. I need to remember who Sidney Powell is. Yes. I don't know who this person is.
I just don't care. As part of the plea agreement, she will get 6 years probation and a fine. Wow, that's almost like...
That's very different.
That's like pedophilia low numbers.
Yeah.
She'll also have to testify or at related cases. And she can't speak with any other witnesses or those involved in the case.
So she just in perpetuity, she has to show up to other people's cases and witness?
No, I think she's got a...
Really inconvenient.
Well, I guess she... Yeah, she has to go there and testify. Yeah.
That's part of the deal.
But then she can't tell anybody about it. That seems wrong.
It does.
Have you ever been on trial?
No, not yet.
No, been to any one of them?
I have not been.
Never in front of a judge.
Well, I've been in front of a judge.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Not on trial.
Not really on trial, but I was sentenced to a few days.
I got you. Yeah. Can I ask what you did?
I drove after drinking.
What kind of a monster?
And then I...
You're a terrible person. Why? Ooh. Nobody in this room would ever do that.
I ran into a car. And then I went home.
Oh, did you?
They got me at my home.
They got you at your home?
All of my friends were like, why'd you answer the door? Even my dad was like, why'd you answer the door? Like, I didn't know that you weren't supposed to answer the door.
Oh, yeah, that's a great thing to do. We used to do that at parties.
Yes, officer?
But then before body cams, they'd still just walk in and be like, oh, it was open.
Oh.
And then it's your word verse there. Did they catch you on film?
No, but I wasn't.
How did they get you?
Because I ran into a car, and the car I ran into got my license plate number.
Oh, okay.
And then I went home, and I put on my pajamas, and then they came and knocked on the door, and I just opened the door.
Oh, they were in the car? When you hit them?
I thought it was a parked car. No. I was going with imagine parked car.
No, I like rear-ended, like at a stop, like very like going 5 miles an hour, not like a bad crash or anything.
Oh, so you just rear-ended somebody and we're like, nope.
I can't maintain enough to get out and just exchange
I love that.
Insurances.
Jammy jam time.
Yeah, you're like, tonight's not the night for this.
I even went to Taco Bell on the way home.
You almost have to in that sense.
Man, you do. It's a good chance to get so. See, I've always thought it was unfair, though, because you're not actively driving. for them just to show up and be like, you could have been like, I felt bad, so I got here and I just started drinking.
Yeah, I just immediately started taking shots.
That's why everyone got mad at me. They're like, why? I just opened the door and was honest. I don't know what was going on in my brain, because when it was happening, I wasn't thinking like, oh, I'm trying to get away with something. I was just like, oh, that wasn't bad. I can't just keep going.
Yeah, you never want to be honest while drunk.
Yeah.
Or with the government.
You're going to go away either way. Well, actually, you should be somewhat honest, because if you are like, look, I had six beers, you might have a fighting chance.
I see what you're saying. You're throwing them a bone.
Yeah, but if you say two, every cop's like, I hate you.
Yeah, I see.
Because I know you're lying. Like, oh, I don't know. I had a couple of drinks. We were at TGI Fridays.
Yeah.
I had some margaritas, and they're like, you just hit a school bus.
It's 3:00 PM.
The side of your car is yellow.
Yeah. We knew it was you. There's shoelaces in your bumper.
But I don't have to go test. I don't have to go to other people's trials.
No. Well, that's good.
Yeah. That would be an escalation.
Was this not like this woman.
Was it in California?
Oh, yeah.
They take your license?
Los Angeles. Van Nuys.
Oh, no. How terrible is the court system there?
Oh, dude, I did everything. That judge hated me.
Oh, really?
She had it out for me. I did 30 days of community service, picking up trash, 6 a.m. in the morning. Mm. Didn't have a license. I had the blower in my car.
Me too.
Did you?
Yeah.
That's embarrassing.
Yeah, I had it for a while. Oh, they're so expensive to calibrate. Yeah. It's the worst.
Is it on you to calibrate them?
Yeah, you have to go get them calibrated once a month, which is means you have to go pay them money. And then a guy who's fake mechanic is like, yeah, it works.
Yeah,
they really didn't have to do anything.
No, and isn't it as
change the filter on it?
Yeah, it's as dangerous. Oh, shit. It is as dangerous as drinking and driving, isn't it?
It's awful.
Because you're driving, especially when you're like LA traffic, and you're like, this is tense. And then all of a sudden it's like, brrr.
See, okay, my understanding is that you had to do it before you could get into the car and like turn it on.
Yeah.
And then you're good until you park.
No, while you're driving, you have to keep doing it.
Oh, that makes sense, because like you could be like, you know, like as you're driving. Yeah,
or you could have somebody blow into it for you, then take off. And yeah, because I've heard people doing that too. Yeah.
Which is odd.
Cops are, they think.
I feel like I would be like, could you just drive my car?
Yeah.
Instead of just blow started for me?
I used to run this scam where I would like have Tinder dates that I would like get to move furniture for me.
Wow. Tell me about that.
Yeah. That's brilliant.
I told you about that. Yes. I was like, oh, okay, a date. But if you want this date to continue, like we need to go to my apartment and move this furniture in this amount of time, basically. But I've got beer there. It's cool. And there was this one guy.
That's hilarious.
That only works because you're a woman. That only works.
Yeah. But this one guy, I gave him a bunch of beers and he never said anything. And then when the night was over, I was like, okay, well, bye. Thanks for moving the furniture. And he was like, no, no, no. I've got a breathalyzer in my car. And I was like, okay. Oh, you son of a bitch. And he was like, I can't go anywhere. I'm here all night.
Damn.
So, oh, I guess we have to have sex.
It was smooth. Yeah, you had to pay him somehow.
Well, yeah.
What are you going to do? You can't really offer pizza and beer when you met him on Tinder.
Yeah.
You know, like, you want some
that
Zaw?
Was the one hitching my plan.
Oh, he got you.
He got me.
Well, I like I like how you're like, it's just for girls. Can you imagine if you brought a woman over on a Tinder date and you're like, listen, I got this couch.
It's a love seat, okay?
Yeah, don't
not just, a full size.
Yeah, don't wear heels or anything. We got
it's
work to do.
It's a fold out, so it's
there
a little heavy.
There is a
heavy.
Bed inside.
Yes. There's a pull out bed, which
I'm not going to be pulling out. But. Yeah.
Sorry, that's a good one.
Got you for life.
It. That's the only thing that will be.
Speaking of pulling out, Biden is sending $60 billion to the Ukraine. Yeah, that's right, $60 billion. In the package also is $40 billion to Israel, Taiwan, and the Mexican border, which is, like, you know, the only one that actually affects us.
How much more does Ukraine need?
You know, all of it.
Was he like, I'm sending money to Israel, but I might as well, we'll just top it off with another.
Hey, we're still good. Zelensky, we're still good. I'll
$60 billion to Zelensky?
Dude, stop sending more money to fund wars. I'm so tired of it, dude. I've been saying the same thing since the freaking Ukraine war thing started. And now that this other war's starting, I'm still saying it. Stop sending my money over there when we got problems here.
Yeah, well, the war's it's definitely gotten violent. From what I understand, I could be wrong.
Okay.
But I believe they haven't gotten along for a while.
You think?
You don't think $40 billion is going to fix it?
I love how the fact that our money... No. I love that we're just, I love that we think that sending our money to the Middle East is going to stop fucking thousands of years of a holy war.
Yeah, it'll work.
Well, I guess not thousands. I guess it was Great Britain, I guess, that went in there and drew in the lines.
The Crusades? Is that what you're talking
about? Yeah.
Well, the Crusades were originally because the Islamic countries were pushing towards Europe.
Yeah.
But then they were going, hey, this like, not anymore.
Like, yeah, like, this is Palestine, though. This is Israel. And now we're going to see our way out.
We walk in there, we fight them. We're like, look, this is it. This is Jerusalem. This is, you guys be cool now. We're going to leave. No, can't leave. Now we're stuck there for thousands of years.
Yeah. I feel like it's not going to help.
Is Biden writing these checks himself?
No,
he can't write.
He can't.
I think he has the...
Well, I'm just wondering why there's such atrocious amounts, because maybe he's actually writing the amounts out.
Well, the 60, the stuff going to Ukraine is actually to a bank account of his.
Yeah, exactly.
Just funneled into Swiss bank
account. The B also stands for Biden. He thought, I write a B there. I don't know where to send
100 Biden dollars.
Yes. Yeah.
Can you imagine?
Send it to the big man.
Like, they probably just put a pen in his hand like a child.
Like a crayon.
And just like it's a...
Like is that Chili's?
Yeah, like a menu at Denny's and just like, yeah, okay.
I got it.
Do I get fries? No, you can't chew those. Okay. Can I have mashed fries? Yeah, that's... He calls them mashed fries because he's old and stupid.
Kamala will chew them up first.
Yes. Oh, God. Spit them in his mouth like a baby bird and Hunter snorts them.
You think she's a spitter?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think she swallows.
What do you think?
Kamala?
And you would know.
You know, she's a pro. She's a pro.
If you're going to look at Kamala, do you think she swallows?
I think she takes it on the face.
Yeah, you're
That's
right.
That's actually, yeah. Not committed.
Where's my head?
She's not letting that thing in her mouth. Come on.
So who do you like, Israel or Palestine?
Oh.
Make a stand right now.
I don't want to do that.
Or you're canceled. Or you're canceled.
Yeah, I'm going to be canceled no matter what I say. More like it.
Yeah, I'm going to go Israel.
I'll err on the side of Israel.
Well, they just got attacked. You're sitting at home on a holy day, and in comes Hamas.
Yeah.
I believe it's called Hamas. It's after somebody in the Midwest.
Hamas, and then...
Hamas comes hummus. In there, and I don't... Oh, there, jeez.
Yeah.
I wish that we were still patriotic and appreciative of our country, the way we once were.
Yeah, you know?
I think it's because the president signs checks with crayons.
Yeah. It's really unfortunate.
I like that he went over... Anyway...
Well, you know, like, what happens when the government doesn't know what it's doing? Economies go down.
They do, but Biden did not do very well going over there, though. We got to mention that.
Oh, that's right.
Because this is going to lead right into that.
Oh, my goodness.
If he would have just brought all the cash, it would have been good.
Yeah, if he just carried around money, like had it handcuffed in a briefcase.
These checks aren't working. He needs to hand out cash.
No, you need
to hold hard cash.
You
need to throw it out.
If he makes it rain, they're going to stop shooting and collect all that money off.
Yeah,
you got to get paid in a briefcase of cash like a famous urban comic at an arena. I'm not even kidding. And then your name is not real. It's like Skittles Magoo. That way there's no way for the IRS to track.
They can't track it.
Like, I don't know. We paid a guy named Skittles Magoo. He wanted a briefcase of cash.
What was that mean? It's great.
He sawed off his bodyguard's hand. Anyway, Biden is not doing very well.
No, he's not.
And he struggled to talk to reporters yesterday. In fact, it took him an average of 2.5 minutes to answer each question. Here's a video.
Virtually every mass shooting, every circumstance where a large number of people have been victimized and lost, I spoke with them. I learned a long time ago what you've all learned in your life. When someone's going through something beyond their comprehension.
Spit it out!
Those were strong words.
I was going to say, I love the face creeping behind him just going...
It looks like somebody tried to make like AI Biden. Like that's not even really him.
What's going on with his chin there?
It looks like he's got like a mask on his face. Like he's wearing a mask on his face or something weird. Like it's not real skin.
Yeah.
I'm just glad that he refers...
The lizard
to a holy war is a mass shooting.
Oh my God, he did.
That's not wrong.
He's just grasping for different topic, like in his head. When the mass shootings happen in the economy, Donald Trump, man.
It's like, there's...
Yeah, please help me.
It hurts when there's mass...
Sir, can you move? I need to get out of the bathroom.
Yeah. Yeah, that guy's just... Is that his wrangler who's not doing his job?
People have taken a screenshot right when the two guys behind him look at each other, and they're just like, what is he saying right now?
Is he wearing a members only jacket?
I think that guy's holding him up from behind.
It's like a puppet. Like he's...
You're right.
Mass shootings.
It's like we're in the middle of a trust fall. And I don't know where all the mass shootings went.
I don't know.
The guy behind him looks like he's going to shoot him on the right.
It's terrifying.
Like, who's watching this guy?
Faces of death.
This guy looks Palestinian and mad. I came with money. And
dude, we are a joke.
Dude, we're going to... I mean, this...
We are a joke.
That is the reason why...
We need to stop all these fireworks happening.
Yeah.
Why is it so loud?
We need to stop celebrating all these things.
They should make fireworks illegal in Israel.
They're dangerous. This is a burn ban.
Dogs don't like them, and then they bite me.
I'll tell you a story. Please don't. Please don't tell the story. Don't.
Please don't tell us a story you half remember.
Sir, sit down.
And half made up. I remember we were stopping a gunfight at the OK Corral. And then there's Sally.
Me, Wyatt Earp. Doc Holliday. Yeah.
And Doc was dying.
The other ones.
Yeah, the other guy. And Sam Elliott said to me, Birch Gold.
Birch Gold.
Speaking of Birch Gold, I believe that's what you were getting into.
That's what I was. It was a great tee-up. But we didn't have to do the video. It was a very terrible video that we needed to present to everybody.
We did need them to see
that. Yes, it was a very...
That's the important. President of the United States.
Yes, we live in a silly country. But you know what's not silly?
Gold. We're all gonna die.
Birch Gold.
Anyway. Concerned Americans, and there are many, basically after seeing that video, are wondering, what do I do? What do I invest in?
Yeah.
What's the deal? I'll tell you what you invest in. Some assets that are physical gold.
Oh, yeah.
Not some stock where it's like, hey, do you want to invest in, I don't know, a pizza company?
It sounded like you said assex.
Assex?
Not assex, assets.
Assets, okay.
Very different.
It must be his accent. He has an accent.
I do. It's my Midwestern accent, and I mispronounce things, and then people tell me later. But if you want to text me for assex, it's 696969. However, if you do want to text Birch Gold to learn much more about their assets, you can get 989898 and just text the word normal, and they're going to send you an absolutely free.
Wow.
Free.
Whoa.
Information.
That's unprecedented.
Thing. They're going to send it to you, and it's going to tell you about their 401k plans, the IRAs, the stuff that you can look forward to going for just gold. Why not go for the gold?
Go for the gold.
What do you want to do?
Birch Gold.
You're not a stock analysis. You don't know anything.
You don't know any of that. And it could go down. You could buy the dip, and it keeps dipping, bro. But you know what doesn't dip? Birch Gold.
No.
Do it. 6'9". Six.
The only time
that's yours. You're mixing me up with your assex. Text normal.
Sometimes that dips.
To 989898. That's 3 9/8s in a row. Text normal. And you'll get that information.
You get a gold kit.
Come on.
It's a gold kit.
Look at it.
It's like the comedy on this show blocked into 14 carat. Or I guess it's all the carats.
It's every carat that you could ever want.
Yeah. So go ahead. Get a hold of Birch Gold.
Depending on how much money you have.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not here to tell you how to live your life. But if I were you, I would invest in gold.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because gold. Or if you do see a company dip because they're very woke, you can buy that stock because it will go back up. It's a fun way to play.
Yeah.
Anyway.
It's like slots.
Yeah, because you're like, there's no way that this isn't going to come back. They sell alcohol. All right. So anyway, the normal, 989898, and get your gold, Birch Gold Group, and they have a gold guarantee, which is it will be gold.
Yeah.
All that glitters is gold, I've heard.
That's right.
Oh.
Are they going to be mad that we grouped them in with assex?
I don't think so.
Okay, good.
I mean, there's...
I don't talk to them.
Well, there hasn't been a great deal of gold exchanged for that.
Oh, yes. Good point. You need the gold
offers,
to get that.
Offers.
Yeah, okay.
It's from what I understand, 30% of all currency.
Yeah.
It's important. Gold's really important. It's a shiny metal that people like.
No, it's true.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
I've worn it.
Oh, yeah?
I wear gold.
I got one right here, yeah. Yeah, this see? In a trash pile.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Well, that's not good for the sponsor.
Well, this isn't birch gold. If this was birch gold, it'd be way better.
Yeah, it wouldn't be in some trash pile.
Oh.
Some guy threw out his wedding ring and you found it?
Well, technically, my wife found it.
I love this.
And she gave it to me.
It's amazing.
Dude, that's awesome. Yeah,
that's pretty great.
Where did you get her wedding ring?
Same trash pile.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
It's like I took it off an old lady's hand at a restaurant.
I just pulled it right off.
Just like, oh, I like that. This is mine now. Yeah, she what? I want it.
She didn't need it. She's like, about to die. How much longer is she going to use it? Now it's going to be on a woman's hand for at least 2 more years.
Yeah, okay.
I like to
shoot for the stars.
I like when people are doing like an Instagram of them saying bye to a loved one and they have like the, you know, the dead hand.
Oh, the dead hand in the shot.
Why not film everything? It's all of our business. Yeah. So I go in there and I go, oh, can I have the ring? And then I just take the ring and I go, you deserve this for what you're doing. And I leave with the ring. Eek. Grandma's dying. Let's put it on Instagram because I'm trash.
Isn't that awful? People take selfies in the hospital and the person dying doesn't even know that they're on Instagram looking so...
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, and this is like, thanks, Grandpa, for everything. And he's back there like...
You make it about you in the worst way possible where you're like, I held his hand as he died. It's like, he held his hand for 5 seconds to take a picture and then you left the room to put it on Instagram.
I mean, we'll all probably be on our deathbed exposed to the world. Probably. All of us here.
But how badly do you need likes that you have to put up you with a dying person and be like, I hope people like this.
Amen.
Yeah, it's like putting...
That's where they grew up.
Yeah, but it's like putting your dog to sleep when people do that. It's like, I don't want to watch this. I want to see two puppies hugging.
Yeah.
Not like there was a woman like playing with, like holding her dog in the garage. And it's like he died 12 minutes after we were making this video. So it's like the dog dying. And I love dogs. And it's like, why didn't you put him down peacefully a month before? Because you were waiting for the video. You Munchausen puppy owner.
Building the set.
Could have just been present with your dog. Passing. I know.
Why wouldn't you just be all right? Like, I've put down dogs. Never once was I like, do we have, make sure my phone's
how's
charged.
The cameras, how's the lighting? Can I get some powder, please?
I don't want to say bye to this animal that had unconditional love for me without the world saying that I have emotion.
Yeah.
Seriously, stop putting up pictures of you putting down your dog.
It's fucking weird.
It's very weird.
Stop it.
Do it of your cat prematurely.
You seem more disturbed by the dog than the actual people that are dying.
I don't give a fuck about people. Yeah,
people are... Dogs don't deserve that.
Trash.
Fuck your grandma, but don't show me that dog.
Yeah,
she was probably raised.
Believe me, I have.
Speaking of, Brands News.
No, I feel bad for her. You brought it up, you read it.
Transgender former football champion made Maxim Australia's top 100 hottest women of the year. Second year in a row, by the way. Danielle.
Oh, God.
You can't even tell.
Oh, yeah, I can't even tell. That's a good job. A good job on that one.
Wow.
Second place.
Must have had a lot of surgeries.
That's 92nd
place.
Yeah, that's Vigo the Carpathian.
Lately played for the West Coast Eagles in North Melbourne, or however they say it in Australia. Football League from Who Cares, and I don't give a shit, so I'm going to continue to go to the next. That was Trans News. Trans News. That is very important.
Man, what a babe.
What a smoke show.
I wish I had a Trapper Keeper for when I stood up.
You got those pillows there.
Yeah. I'm going to have to cover with a pillow when I walk out.
I thought you were going to say you wish you had more gold.
I know. I wish I had.
They don't pay us to talk about them twice.
No.
Just once.
I wish I had gold. Well, that's good that she's transitioning, but I guess she hasn't looked in a mirror and realized it already was mostly there.
Yeah.
Sure. That's what you call, you'd be tricked, right? If you're at a party and she was like, hey, man.
Like I'm taking this.
You'd be like, hi, baby. I like your tits.
I don't think you would ever find out the truth.
No.
Oh, that's a good
Now topic. I get weird because like I'll be like at an airport. I'm a guy. I do my best not to stare and be creepy because I'm a merry guy.
Yeah, you respect it from the distance.
I'm not out there to. Ma'am. I'm not out there to play the field.
No.
So I wear sunglasses to the beach. And the sun. Know, that's all. That's why guys were wearing sunglasses at the beach, by the way. Because
yeah. Otherwise, they just burn their eyes. I don't care.
Well, yeah, but I just look over, like, you know, because you can't, if your sunglasses are there, people can't get mad at you. Mm-hmm. When it's like, is that guy staring? It's like, you don't know. These are pretty dark shades. Anyway, I shouldn't admit these things. But yeah, now when I see like really, really, really hot, look, see, really hot women, I'm not sure if it's a guy because they do a good job now.
You can't tell where I'm looking.
So I just look down.
I'm looking all over this.
Hey, you don't know what's going on. You checking me out, baby? There.
Look at that.
You checking me out?
Yeah. But you can't tell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to look down. You got to look at the thighs.
Is that what it is?
I feel like I can tell a dude and a woman by thighs.
Is it the penis in forgiven? Between them?
Usually. Usually.
Sometimes that's the dead giveaway.
Quads.
Dead giveaway.
Quads. That's quite a clit. It's 9 inches hard. I found the clit. It has balls.
It's balls attached to it.
Like high five on your guy friends.
Yeah, I found one.
Sweet, bro. You know how it is. We can't ever find them. I found it right away.
I don't know how you guys don't know where it is.
Yeah,
dude. Massive.
Yeah, it's like the biggest. It's unbelievable. It's
huge.
I had to lift it up to get through a vagina. And you're like, what? Like,
it was super tight, bro. Super tight.
You guy has no idea.
It was sealed shut.
Yeah, I tried to put it in there, but I don't know. She was too tight. Just jamming himself in the taint. He's like, what? I don't know. This isn't working. Oh, man. Is this your first time, babe?
That's why it's bleeding.
Yeah. I better go get a towel, babe. This is so weird. It's your first time when I'm paying you $200. Oh, man. True story. Oh,
man. It's weird how good you are at sucking dick when you've never done this before.
It's incredible. Oh. Yeah, you like when I go down on you like that? When I work the clit shaft? Where are the most nerves at? They're like, I don't know, I play soccer.
That's what they sound like.
I was on
the 92nd on
the
top 100.
88 football Olympics. I'm glad you're I hope you like that. I'm not into anal. No, I'm not either. I'm not either, gay. Man. You know, it's for gay guys. Anyway, Bigfoot. Speaking of Bigfoot.
Great transition.
That was a good transition. It wasn't.
I know it wasn't. It was a few minutes ago. last week we... I wonder if we get pulled on this one.
This one might be.
But it's funny. Like, I don't... who really cares who anybody...
I saw somebody in the chat was like, I was going to commend Garrett on not using curse words. But then he used one. Shame on him.
People watch.
Like, have you watched this show?
People watch this for cleanliness?
Are you 80?
Yeah, I'm sorry. And technically, I didn't use any curse words. I actually used clinical terms just now. Yeah. Well, maybe not Shaft, but he's a bad mother.
Watch your mouth.
What?
Watch your mouth. One of the greatest intros to a movie. That movie's fucking awesome.
The original with Richard
Roundtree?
It
just keeps going and going. And they play the whole song, and he's just walking through New York. He's just going because he's bad.
Dude, Richard Roundtree is amazing.
Yeah, he's awesome.
And I love Samuel Jackson.
Yeah, it was very. Yeah, he's also a good Shaft.
It was all right.
I didn't watch the new one, but I heard that the newer one with the Shaft's grandson, where there's like three Shafts.
I haven't seen that.
Original Shaft, then it's Samuel Medium Jackson, Shaft. And then it's his son, and then it's like an action movie, and I heard it's actually pretty good.
I would watch
it. I've never seen it. We should do a review on it.
Let's do it.
It's a very, very late review.
It's a good name for a movie, Three Shafts.
It really is.
That was the pornos.
Night Shaft. Yeah. Ebony Shafts.
Son of Shafts.
Three Shafts. Son of Shafts.
Yeah, you go in thinking it's Shaft.
Yeah.
You're like, no, it's three of them, and then you're just like, this is just a human centipede of men. You're like, son, I think I went to the wrong movie.
Why is this movie only 12 minutes?
Went to the wrong theater.
Why is everybody clapping, but I can't see their hands? What place is this?
Pee Wee Herman was sitting right next to me. Yeah.
Do you like this movie? What? Huh? Huh? I think he said uh-huh. Yeah.
Anyways, Bigfoot. I don't So last week, Bigfoot. We covered this possible Bigfoot sighting in Colorado. Play the clip.
It's an elusive creature. All right, just squat it down. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me see your camera. I'll do
elusive creature, the Bigfoot.
Now, Jen, you saw that. What do you think? Authentic Bigfoot?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I think real.
Yeah, for sure.
They hide in deserts in front of thousands of people.
Yes.
Yeah.
Where they know people are.
Yeah.
You think Bigfoot's real?
Yeah.
I'm just happy that you agree.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think he's living in Australia.
Yeah, most likely.
Oh. It's on Maxos Top 100? Yeah.
What happened to us? I just got that. Well,
in the last week.
Well played, Jen Murphy. I didn't mean to say your full name.
Yeah. Said it like
she doesn't want people to
grandpa.
Know.
Grandpa.
No, yeah, can we bleep that out,
please? She lives in California.
Can you make my face fuzzy on this show?
The whole time, just embarrassed to be on here. So Bigfoot okay. expert
Many
came in.
I'm a lesbian. Go on.
Do you like, what kind of chocolate do you like?
I like a bit of both. Okay. No, I like milk.
Chinese hedging is best.
But I'm not saying I won't eat dark. I'm not racist.
Okay.
What?
But, hey.
Were we on the same topic?
We're talking about Bigfoot.
I thought you were talking about
Three Chefs. Very serious.
I was just picturing you being a lesbian. I got lost. Sorry.
No, I had a mullet too for a little while, and I actually have talked about it on the show. I got misgendered. I was buying a smoothie,
because of the mullet?
So it's my fault. But yeah, a guy was just like, "Excuse me, ma'am," and I was like, "Yeah," and he was like, "I'm so sorry." He's like, "You want free yogurt pretzels?" I'm like, "Yeah, that'll make me feel like
I'll take them.
Big, handsome woodsman."
I'll take them.
I walk out.
I love that it's because you had a mullet.
Yeah.
It was the mullet.
I miss the mullet.
I do too. I think you should have kept going with it. Are you growing it back out?
I am. I had to get the neck surgery, so they had me cut it. I had to get what turned out not to be cancer, which, you know, well, I was hoping. And it turned out not to be.
Oh, you think that's good?
Yeah, the scar they left way worse than the original bump. I would have just had them leave it. I was like, this is the worst job you did. But when you pay a guy who barely knows English $50 to work on your neck, sort of on you.
Yeah.
Did you go to Tijuana to get this?
Home Depot. So yes.
He was a janitor. He just asked him.
Just like not even one of the ones outside.
Oh.
I'm like, did you work on the bathrooms here? Yeah. Did you do
yes,
the
yes.
Can if I lay on a pull-out koala machine, one of those changing tables, will you just
come here?
You just cut this off my neck? It's like, oh, yeah.
They all have box cutters.
Yeah, they're like, I got knives.
Yeah, I'm right here.
Why wouldn't I?
Bring them. Whoosh.
If I
sent it off.
He would have known how to save the mullet if that was the case.
That's true.
He would have figured it out.
I used to get my hair cut by Dominicans because I lived in Harlem. And it was great every time they did it because I would have like lines in my head. I'm like, clearly.
They're like putting like details. And
yeah, looks. But I enjoyed it. But it was funny because it's like, you just don't cut white hair. And I'd be sitting down and like Detroit was like that, where one time I went in there and like, it was just, I went into a black barber shop and it was in the hood. It wasn't like just a black person who cuts hair. It was just a barber shop. It was like called Ace of Fades, like the kind of place you don't, it's not for me.
Yeah.
I've had great ghetto barber shops give me great haircuts. But this time, I don't think they were pleased to see me because I had like the Lloyd Christmas Dumb and Dumber, except it was sideways. And all I had to do was thank them. I'm like, well, I'll be wearing a hat for a while. And there's a good chance they did it on purpose just to mess with me.
They tried to think of the whitest haircut they could get.
Yeah, they're like, how stupid can we make him look? And then see and watch him just.
He's like, how does look? How does look?
Yeah, watch him just take it out of guilt.
Was there not a Supercuts or Fantastic Sam's in the area?
There was not. There was a place called Sam's, but it was a liquor store. And there was
next to the barbershop.
Supercuts is such a that can be in an affluent white area,
huh?
Or any terrible grocery store.
Yeah, I almost exclusively get my haircut there
at terrible grocery stores.
Yes.
When I walk out, I don't want a Walmart. I'm sorry if you cut hair at a Walmart. I feel that you're beneath me.
Yeah. You treat them like
I don't tip them as much.
Yeah.
I'm kidding.
They know.
Ladies, I think that cutting hair is a very... I can't do it.
I went and got an expensive haircut once because I was like, eh, maybe I'll do that. I'm like, I'm on camera. So let's... And it was like, you know, I say expensive, like $40. Like double the cost I spent on haircuts. And it wasn't good.
Yeah.
It was trash. And I had to do the same thing. Like, oh, just put a hat on. And then I went to a Supercuts and it was $20. Nice lady. Cut it perfectly. I hate getting my hair cut. I hate talk, like small talk, like, oh, how's your day? What's the matter? People touching my head and stuff. It's weird.
I can't stand small talk.
No. Then I'm small, so I usually just go to a place where I can sit in a plane.
You can spin the propeller.
And then
hey, you get a popsicle.
And I dress my son up, who's 8 like a grown man, and he pays.
He's a little mustache.
Yeah, he's like, thank you very much for cutting my boy's hair. He really enjoyed the plane.
He's like, no, I'm back.
He's like, oh, man, all these years of hard work. This kid's not worth anything.
This kid.
Like, you get it, if you get a haircut, is there a lot of small talk, or do you go to a friend?
Oh, I go to a friend.
Which I believe is a crime in California.
No, I mean, I don't mind talking sometimes. I usually would just grab a magazine and then start reading as soon as you sit down. And I think they get the hint that you don't want to talk.
I like that.
That's a good play.
That's why I talk loudly on the phone everywhere I go. Airports, lines. I'm a real ass. I don't do that.
I'm a real ass.
There's nothing I hate more than when somebody's just like on the phone. I almost saw a guy. It was a guy who was buying lottery tickets on the phone very loud. And then the man behind the counter, who was an Asian gentleman. We can admit, okay, an Asian and a black guy, they didn't get along for some reason at a 7-Eleven. I know you're stunned. But I was in line next to him, and it was getting heated. He's like, do I got to come back in here with a weapon? And I'm sitting there man, I just want to buy a Slurpee. But then he gave me a fist bump and then left, and I was like, I'm going to get out of here before it gets south.
That was a sign. He was like...
Yeah, but they were very mad at each other. And right when he walked out, the guy goes, oh, to kick his ass. And I was like, okay. Just whatever, dude.
Okay.
You had your chance to act tough. You didn't.
I don't understand how people talk loudly on speakerphone.
No,
you're just hearing everything. I'm so self-conscious about talking. I try and hide in a corner if I'm in public.
Yeah. I hate it.
In a movie theater when they start talking on the phone. I almost like blow my top off.
You are a worthless person if you think that's acceptable.
Yeah, or if you're on like public transportation and no earbuds or anything, they're just playing their music as loud as they want. And you're like, why do you think the rest of us want to hear this?
Yeah.
Or even if I'm on a plane next to somebody and it's like even before it takes off, but it's about whatever stupid business they have. And the guy keeps repeating like a business phrase where it's like, that's just why we have to go in there and, you know, wet their beaks. And you're like, I just want to leave. And he's like, just go in there, wet your beak, and then get me back the information. And then it'll pause, and he'll again go, just make sure you wet your beak, get me back the information. And you're like, I hate you so much. Like, why? Like, if you're that important, why are you sitting in the middle seat?
That's what he's trying to set the tone to let you know he's important.
It's like, look, I shouldn't be in this.
I can't be bothered.
Seat.
He just prefers middle seats.
Yeah. I get both of the armrests, okay, because I'm in the middle.
Excuse me, I'm going to be on a laptop the rest of the flight doing a job that looks like it should have been eliminated 20 years ago. But they're just hanging on because I know the owner.
Exactly.
I saw when I was on a plane to the UK, there was a guy and he was watching Suits and he was doing MS Paint at the same time. So he was like building little like schematics and MS Paint and watching Suits. The entire, like 9 hours straight.
Oh my God.
And this was brutal.
Pleasurable for him?
I don't know, dude. It was hurting me. I just like watching that show with no sound and not knowing what was going on.
It sounds like the movie Saw.
A little bit.
Like if you had to watch Suits.
Yeah. Oh
God. It's like you're going to have to watch this for nine hours. And you're like, just poke my eyes out already, Jigsaw.
That show's the same show. The same scene every single episode. There's one person in a room. One person walks in. They talk for a while. That person leaves.
What's your favorite
show? Maybe those guys were just his inspiration.
He's like, I want to be them.
Yeah.
That's me.
Yeah.
One day I'm going to be Johnny Suits.
I can have sex with Meghan Markle.
Yep. Is she on that show?
She is, yeah.
She was on Suits?
Yeah.
I believe she gets the nude.
Yeah, I guess after that she did some stuff.
Who knows what it is?
We don't know what happened to her.
She married a prince and was like, that's not good enough. And
destroyed his family.
Yeah,
made him not a prince anymore.
Right? Yeah. What's wrong with these men?
Why would you ever? It's a prince.
Yeah. Now he's living in Santa Barbara.
Yeah, what a loser.
He's working at a bowling alley.
He lives down the street from Ellen.
Yeah.
Like what size shoes?
That's true. Like how he's not roughing it.
No, he's not. It's a beautiful place where he lives.
Like if he ever gets in trouble, he can just call for the crown jewels to get him out of it.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, hey, king.
Dad.
Didn't the old bitch die, the queen?
Yeah, she did.
I didn't mean
I'm sorry, joke. British people. You get really mad about your queen because I made like a slight, just not even a mean joke whenever she passed away, and they all got mad at me.
Well, do you see that people would standing in line for like 15 hours just to pass by her casket?
You're very
like,
serious. Right.
Nobody in America cares that much about anybody.
No way.
No.
I think they should just wheel her body down the line. Get it all done with
an
hour.
Why do we have to walk up to her? She's already dead. Put her in a wheeler.
It's like a parade. Just have her hand up doing that.
Wheeler ass on by and be done with it.
And everybody can, and she's doing her queen wave. She looked 90 for 40 years.
Yeah, forever.
Yeah, when I found out
before that smoke show. Have you seen pictures of her? She looked
great. No.
Great. When? In her 20s?
Yeah, in the 20s.
Smoke show. Yeah, I was going to say in the 20s.
Oh, man. I bet she has some bush.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just judging by the fro she had at the end of life.
That's why they waited 15 hours. Yeah.
Oh, I thought you
finally Wasn't get to see her bush.
You get to see her white. Does the royal carpet match the drape?
Oh, it does.
I wouldn't wait that long to see somebody alive. Why would you wait that long to see him dead?
No, I wouldn't see
it. It's the Queen of England. I don't know.
But Betty White you wouldn't even wait that long for, and that's somebody who's worth doing it for.
I might wait for that.
Betty White, is that her?
So yeah, hot.
Yeah, she's,
wow,
bad.
What a piece.
Not bad for the 20s.
I'd say, I don't know, man. She looks covered in lice and like she can only take cold baths every 2 weeks.
I can't see it.
I'm by me.
I bet there's a stink.
a presidential. She ain't
no, just in that era. Like when they really were like, you couldn't shower all the time.
Yeah.
Your teeth weren't good.
Yeah, you were spraying like...
Imagine sex back then before showers.
Bug juice on you. Ugh.
Like you couldn't, you'd really have to like someone.
Yeah.
Otherwise you're just like.
But I guess they didn't know any different. And so you just get acclimated to the smell.
That's true. If you are used to it, it's like living in a house with a bunch of smokers.
Yeah, and you don't even notice it anymore.
No, you're just used to the fact that everyone smells like hot garbage. And then if you're actually I bet if you put on a little cologne back then, women were like, who's this guy? Mm-hmm. This is enchanting.
I bet it would really stink now. Because she's dead.
Well, yeah. Yeah. Necrophilia stinks only in the sense of smell.
What?
Otherwise, it's great. Don't you find it funny when coroners get in trouble for having sex with the bodies?
And you're like, yeah, duh.
That's part of the job.
I know, it really is. Like, why
not surprise? You get into it.
Yeah, because you have to, like, at least one in five.
They're not hurting anybody.
I'm thinking more than one in five, because, like, you have to be already kind of weird to be a coroner. So it's not that far of a leap.
Well, yeah, how bad can you ruin that job?
Yeah.
Plus, sometimes they say, like, people die, but they still feel have some senses. Maybe these people are enjoying themselves as they're transitioning to the next life.
That's true. They're probably enjoying being raped by a coroner.
The weirdest people on earth.
I wouldn't enjoy that.
How much would that suck if you do have, like, complete feeling? You're like, well, I'm still...
Damn.
I'm still kind of here.
Can't wait to go to heaven and see Grandma. What?
What is this?
Like, is
Stop
this...
it!
Is this
how we launch?
Is this heaven? This doesn't
heaven sucks.
Yeah, heaven sucks.
Why is it cold? Why is my mouth shut and I'm wearing sewn shut and I'm wearing so much makeup?
Maybe that's why they originally started sewing the mouth shut.
Probably is.
Oh man.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, Phil, stop it.
They do it after. To get rid of any evidence, they're just coming there with their needle and thread.
They'll keep having sex with the freaking bodies.
You like crocheting?
Why is grandma foaming at the mouth?
Oh, I don't know.
That's not foam.
It was in her will.
We're going to have a closed casket.
Yeah. She, I don't know. She has to be gangbanged by coroners. Your grandmother was dirty. She used to go to, my grandma used to go to Mardi Gras.
Oh, yeah? Did she get crazy?
Probably.
You've seen pictures? See, yeah. Or how do you know this?
She used to have beads and shit all over
her
house.
I hope so.
Oh, yeah, she was an Elkie. She was in recovery, but yeah, she, like, I knew she was like a trollop. Oh. I used the term of her time.
Of her time, yeah.
Trollop. She's a real trollop. She got around. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I liked her. She's fine, yeah. She's my grandmother.
That's great.
She was always
she had fun. I look at old people and I think,
oh, yeah.
I bet they had fun.
She was getting dicked down.
Yeah.
I bet she had fun, yeah. Somebody told me that when I was doing a comedy show years ago, because I would get nervous when there was older people in the crowd, and they'd be like, you know they did all the shit that you've done.
Right?
Like, just because they're older.
They went to...
Does that mean they never had sex?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
No, American soldiers, when they were in France, they were like, all right, whores. And then they just brought it back to America. Like, all of them, they're like, I'm going to kiss you on the street, and this is going to be a great black and white photo, but little do you know what I've been eating.
What I've been eating?
This whole time.
Whores.
French whores. They call it French kissing.
Yeah, well, French whores were they're still there.
Oh, yeah.
I'm told.
Yeah.
Why do they call it Arabic French kissing? Now,
I don't know. I think the French invented it.
Did they?
I think the French were like, hey... Let's use tongues, too.
Kissing and the fries? How do they invent the other greatest things?
And croissants and smoking. Yeah.
Come on.
And baguettes.
What is happening?
Someone's going to correct me on smoking.
Yeah, they are.
And unicycling. You know what? They created mimes, so that's also a
that's
problem.
Oh, that's right,
we can do without mimes. It's like, no, I get it. You're in a box. That's great. Thanks for doing this in a park.
Oh, it's a rope? What? It's not a rope.
Why don't they get in trouble? Saying. Why don't they get in trouble for painting their face white?
Yeah, it's true. You know, if you're gonna run like a mob, you should have mimes. They're never gonna be stoolies.
Like the Warriors, didn't they have a mime gang?
Like a mime on a gang trial, trying to explain it through actions.
Write it down.
Like, this guy doesn't seem intimidating at all. He's wearing a stupid Hamburglar outfit with a beret. I don't like
those little sashes.
I can tell.
Like sash.
I just, living in New York, you realize that it's like street magic. Mm. You're like, I didn't ask for this. Go away.
You're bad.
Well, I think there's also like, you appreciate performances where you're like, how are they doing that? But it's like, you're just...
Yeah, there's no mystique to that.
No.
Just pretending you're in a box.
And there's no reveal at the end.
No. You're not like...
It's the skill. It's like the robot. When you see someone that can do the robot, and when somebody can really do the robot, you're like, oh, that's pretty cool. And it's kind of like that.
It's cool for about 20 seconds.
Yeah, and then you walk away.
And then you get on your train. Because no one's ever been paid to do the robot.
Get on your train.
Just stupid breakdancers. I'm sorry. We let's talk about
this is a show.
I know we're running out of time, but I think it's important. We have somebody from LA here. So in her new book, Jada Pinkett Smith claimed not to be a member of the Church of Scientology, but she said she embraced the church's basic study manual.
What the fuck?
You're done.
Ooh, it's spooky.
You're just done.
The Church of Scientology runs the show, so I'm sorry.
Yeah, they came in here trying to stop us.
I had a feeling they were going to do that.
Tom Cruise.
Ah, well.
I didn't like the last movie you made.
All right, I got to stop since they are the people who... we'll talk about it next week. But I want to say... Thank you, Jen, for coming on the show.
Was that music really to tell you you're done?
You have to, because I brought up Scientology, and
the big guy upstairs.
Sorry, there's
cabbage.
There's people that own us.
Yeah,
and we may have stepped out of line just now.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's very scary. We have to take that thing where you put the cans in our hands. Uh-huh. They've never explained to me what it is, but you just have to go through the motions. You know.
It's pretty bad. Like,
so we can come back.
We have to give John Travolta a massage.
Yeah. And by massage, you know.
Oh, yeah. I know. Trust me.
It's a very hetero massage.
Yes.
What we do is we eat his pussy.
It's really tight.
It's very tight.
It's very, oh, good callback.
I hate when I make myself laugh at the dumbest. Welcome to Scientology. Today we'll be eating
John Travolta's pussy
on a plane.
And you're going to like it.
It'd be weird to be on a plane with him, though. That was one of the things where he wasn't, that's where they accused him, on a plane.
On a plane?
And he's also a pilot. You know, he's the guy that's like, hey, you think I'm going to land this thing? And then he's just naked laying on a table. He's like, you let me know if we're going to make the landing. You got to be like, do you like that?
Yeah.
Tell me face like off lower. Was good. Face off was good.
You would have one of those Audi pussies.
He would.
Oh,
and a landing whatever.
With those long ones with balls.
Strip. Just because he's a pilot.
I like to keep the theme going.
What? It's just all the way down. Do. You know. Yeah.
I played an angel in the Michael movie.
Have you ever like seen that. Staying Alive?
Oh, God, yeah.
No.
And directed by Sylvester Stallone.
I've watched it so many times.
There is no more homoerotic film, and he is covered in grease the whole movie. Like, I think Sylvester, if you ever seen Sylvester Stallone directing it, there's photos of him, and I love Stallone, but he's just sitting there, and R.I.P., Paulie.
Paulie, R.I.P.?
Yeah. For real, loved him. And it's him, and he's just wearing a tassel jacket with no shirts and a Speedo, and he's just holding a megaphone directing John Travolta. But you know the whole time he's like, I don't know, more grease, but I put more grease on him.
Put him down with some more baby.
He's wearing a Speedo?
Yeah, oh, there's so many pictures of Stallone in the 80s hanging out at his house, like, with his parents, and he's just like in a thong, all ripped, like getting the mail almost completely naked, like once he became a bodybuilder. It's fantastic.
Oh my God.
And I like Stallone.
You know, Stallone's mom had fitness tapes.
Did she really?
Yes. She had a whole fitness tape line. It was like, actually, it wasn't just her, it was like her and other celebrities' parents.
Jane Fonda?
Maybe.
Carol Summers.
It's like a group of them, and they were like, let's jazzercise kind of thing.
I think Staying Alive is quite brilliant. I think John Travolta is amazing in that movie.
He is.
His dancing is insane.
Yeah, it's almost like he's a gay man.
Yeah.
No.
Almost.
No, come on.
Come on, he's covered in oil. There's not a scene in that movie where he's not covered in oil.
Could you imagine the oil budget on that film?
And he had to dance. How many times must he have slipped?
Oh, a lot.
All the other dancers are slipping on his oil.
Yeah, because in Saturday Night Fever, he's wearing clothes.
Yeah.
And then in this one, he's wearing a headband and oil.
That's where you save money for the oil and the costuming.
Was that for a wardrobe? It's like, yeah. It's mainly just oil.
That's it. It's big, big bucket of oil here. And
oh, that's great. Yeah, his headbands. I can't do a Travolta.
It was good enough.
Hey, oily.
It's like a senile Travolta.
Yeah, and he's dying. Hey, oil. It's
what does Travolta sound like? I have no clue.
I only hear Vinnie Barbarino from Welcome Back, Kotter.
Okay.
What do you think Stallone and Travolta did after they were filming out daily?
Coke.
Yeah. Each other
or cock,
yeah. cock and coke.
Not Stallone though. I like Stallone, but I don't know. I don't mind Travolta. I just know that the Scientology allegedly covers up his.
Don't say that again. The music's gonna come back.
Oh sure. Yeah,
don't.
Scientology.
We'll play our own ad for the Halloween special that's coming up on Halloween Day. All sketches.
Yeah, you don't want to watch that. John Travolta is allegedly in two of them.
Yes, that's a fact.
He plays a bush, a landing strip. All right, so Jen, where can we find you?
Well, I'm in Dallas this weekend, but that's probably too soon.
This is going out tonight.
Yes. Oh, okay. Well, I'm at the Comedy Arena in McKinney.
There you go. Yeah.
Wait, for real?
Yeah.
Hey.
Two shows Friday, two shows Saturday.
Guys, go out to the Comedy Arena and support Jen.
Yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah, four shows this weekend. Do it.
Come out.
Do it.
Come out.
It's in McKinney. You don't even have to go into.
It's not even that far. You don't have to get stabbed or anything. It's a fairly nice place.
Nice little area, McKinney.
Yeah.
Well, good.
Is there anywhere else that they can find you?
They can find me on Instagram at Jen Murphy Comedy.
There you go.
After this weekend, I'll be back in LA for a while.
Hanging out.
Local shows. The Improv, Comedy and Magic Club. I do that one.
I love Comedy and Magic
Club. Love it so much.
It is one of my favorite clubs in the world.
It's the greatest.
I don't know if they still have the lobster mac and cheese.
No, I don't think
that
they
sounds
do.
Awesome.
Or the lobster shrimp mac and cheese. I would order it every time. The manager, Richard, is an amazing human being.
Yeah.
And when I lived in LA, he put me up almost every night.
Wow.
And it was
very nice.
It was when, too, like, I would host to meet people. So you'd be like, there'd be like Tosh and Gary Shandling and all these like amazing people. Like there, and there still are. I mean, it's constant. Like, but yeah, that's such a great room.
Yeah, I love it.
If you live near Hermosa Beach and you've never walked in there, you need to. It's such a wonderful room for comedy.
All right, Dave.
Hey, Magic Lab.
Yeah.
Where can you see you?
This weekend, you can see my sweet ass at the Funny Bone. I feel like I'm gonna get fired. At the Funny Bone in Toledo, Ohio, October 21st, only Saturday, because tomorrow night I'm going to KISS.
Oh, what?
Mm-hmm.
What?
I'm not saying it's the greatest band ever, but when you have a son who can play him on drums.
Wow, that's impressive. Yeah.
So, not my favorite band ever. They are very repetitive, but it's KISS. It's fucking KISS.
Legends.
Yeah.
Legends.
I just hope they sell merch. And also, I hope no one took that literally, I will be at the Funny Stop the week after, and that will be in Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio. I said this yesterday, my friend who owned the club passed away, his wife's running it right now. If you can come out and support that, I would really greatly appreciate it, and I know the family would as well. They were really good people, one of the first guys to headline me. So if you come out to the Funny Stop in Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio, come out, and then... I got other dates. I don't want to brag.
Oh, you're going to keep them secret?
Oh, November 2nd. I want to throw that out. Maxwell Hughes and I, for former Lumineer, and he's performed on this show.
Yes, he has.
He and I are going to... Yeah,
Cat Stevens.
Yeah, yes. I don't know if he wants people to know that right now. but we will be in Colorado Springs, Colorado. So come out to that November 2nd, right after Halloween.
Hey, you might see Bigfoot.
You might see Bigfoot.
Yeah, I'm going to go looking for him. I hear he's in.
He should.
Yeah, he was an Aussie.
Yeah. You can find me on Friday Night Tights tomorrow on Nerdronic's channel. We talk about nerd stuff. We talk about all kinds of pop culture things. You can find me also on my channel on Sundays and on Mondays on Adam Krigler's channel, where we get a bunch of people. You know Flawed? Flawed TV? We do a show with him on Adam's channel, so check it out.
And remember, like I say at the end of every day, go out there and dream bigger than your heart can even think.